In the first video of this series on autonomous mobility, we went during summer 22 to Phoenix and San Francisco to discover the Robotaxi services operated by Waymo and Cruise. This video showed that the technology is advancing rapidly, even though many challenges remain. Since our visit, these two companies have continued their deployment in San Francisco and have announced imminent developments in other American cities. The situation is very different from Europe, when there have been some tests of autonomous vehicles, but mainly in the form of shuttles operating at low speeds in specific areas. These tests have not been very conclusive and show the gap in technological maturity between Europe and the United States, as well as a more cautious regulatory context. What is actually the difference between a shuttle and a robotaxi? To get an insight, let's talk to Marc Ambla, a local mobility expert based in Palo Alto.
Shuttles have been around for a few years already in terms of pilots. The pioneers have deployed each 200-300 vehicles around the globe. So we have pockets of, you know, 2, 3, 4, 5 vehicles here and there around the world. And these vehicles follow the same route, always going from A to B to C to D and then back to A, following the same path. That's what we call going through waypoints. So these vehicles are programmed to follow this path. They can deviate by a few meters outside the path, but not more. Whereas robotaxis are designed to operate from any point A to any point B within a given operating design domain, ODD. And that's a major difference. So the shuttles operate more as an alternative or complement to public transit, which typically follow a repeating path, whereas the robotaxis is more akin a taxi going again from any point to any point within a certain area.
We can clearly see the difference between Europe, where autonomous vehicles are thought as a complement to public transport, and the United States, where robotaxis aim to replace traditional taxis and ride-hailing services and offer point-to-point travel. This is precisely the case of the company Cruise, backed by General Motors, that has been the first allowed to operate its vehicles at night in San Francisco, but in a fairly limited area. Since our visit in August, Cruise has greatly expanded the area served and has just announced the launch of daytime operations. The service is open to the public who have registered on a waiting list. The demand is enormous and there are thousands of people who want to try it. To find out what San Francisco residents think about autonomous mobility and whether they're ready to use these services, we went to the Nob Hill district to meet Anne-Marie and Michael, who work and live there, as well as José, who works at Cruise.
Well, we talked briefly, and initially I think we need to get some of the kinks out, because I've seen some of the video footage, and especially with respect to Tesla, the self-driving car is not really self-driving, and people assumed that you could get in and just push a button and go, and it was driver assist. So I think the language needs to be corrected. But after talking to you briefly and thinking about what it means to be a woman and out at night and needing a ride, I would definitely give it a try. My son also cannot drive because of a medical condition, and I've been keeping my eye on this story for quite some time, thinking that he would be an ideal candidate too.
My first opportunity when I took the ride was amazing, because the car was clean. I sat down, it was quiet. I just got off work. But me sitting there and the car doing it by itself and everything was really nice, because I got to decompress, and how the car drove didn't make me nervous, because it stopped at every intersection, and every person, there was a couple people tried to jump in front of it, and how reactive and quick it was stopping and knowing the surroundings of it made me feel really comfortable, and very much, I was telling more people about it.
At the end of every ride, the rider can rate the ride, you know, from 1 to 5, and it's been pretty high up there. In the high 4 or 5, close to 5. And I think what they're most impressed of is kind of just the way it drives, right? It's a autonomous vehicle, no driver, people aren't used to it, but it drives like a human being. It drives safe, it doesn't drive recklessly.
Would it help with parking? Yes. The cost of parking, my car, 3 blocks down, beautiful neighborhood, I love living here, but the first 2 months I moved in, my car was broken into 3 times. So it would be nice not to have to pay the insurance, nice not to have to worry about parking and navigating the hills. It's expensive.
I know, but I guess maybe me being in San Francisco, we're so used to trying new things that it was, to me, being in the car was like better than a human driving it.
I like to joke that the only thing that's not human-like about our vehicles is that it follows the speed limit. I think it's an electric vehicle, so it's quiet as well, so it makes for a very smooth ride.
You know, the way that I do see the future is a lot of the times we get off really late at work, and it's 2 o'clock in the morning, 3 o'clock in the morning, 4 o'clock in the morning. And at times, with what's going on right now, you need more human to be driving out there to get to A, B, and C. It's kind of nice to know that you don't have to rely on that. There's an external driving vehicles out there, so you're able to call for a car and go, let's say, to Oakland and to any location that you're going to.
If you told me I could trade my car for a self-driving car and it cost me the same monthly, I would definitely consider it.
These testimonials show us that the people served by these autonomous services seem ready to use them, especially if the prices of the rides go down. Citizens could get rid of their car and avoid the hassle of parking and paying for owning a car. These robotaxis could facilitate the mobility of people who are not able to drive. It also gives the opportunity to relax after a night shift work and to improve road safety. The promise of the robotaxi is to offer cheaper individual mobility. In order to reduce the cost for users, Waymo and Cruise are designing shared vehicles capable of transporting several people in the same direction. Robotaxis might evolve into on-demand shuttles. In our next video, we will discover how automation technology is applied to areas other than robotaxis, including freight transport. We will see that Waymo, among others, is developing fully autonomous trucks.